Hello, good in the middle of the night. For me, this is Rob Koster for Card Game Expert, and today I'm going to be talking about the history of Death Shadow. So this is the most requested card to talk about by a lot. So I think Death Shadow on its own got more requests for videos than, well, literal every other card in the format. So I figured, why not? Let's get into it, do some Death Shadowing tonight. And this is the first list that I could find that played it. This is from 2012. This is to be exact from 22nd of October in 2012. It's from a modern daily, so nothing too special. Modern daily is basically like what a league is these days. And this deck is playing three Death Shadows, and it's the first list that I could find with the card in it. It's very obvious what this list is trying to do. So let's move you over there. What this list is trying to do is going to kill you mostly. So you have three spells in Gutshot and some duress to protect your creatures, some slaughter pacts in here as well, some assault strobe. This is the pre-version of Temur Battle Rage. Don't worry, you'll see that card a lot in the future. Assault strobe, just the early version of it. Sorcery speed, one mana, target against double strike, no other stuff. And then you're like, wait, why is Niv-Magus elemental here? And that's because we have storm spells in here. So Ground Rift is a storm spell that when you play it and you get a bunch of copies, you can exile each single copy to the Niv-Magus elemental. So the idea here is to just kind of storm off, make like 20 copies, or not even 20, like 10 copies of this, and then eat them all with the Niv-Magus elemental. And then just attack in and potentially give it double strike as well. So definitely just attack based around Niv-Magus Elemental and Killing Fiend and just kind of tagging along the Death Shadow. Because there's a ton of damage in here to yourself as well. So lots of life loss in the form of, as I already mentioned, Gutshot. There's Cachexian Probe. There's Gutshot again. There's Mutagenic Growth as well. So lots of stuff losing life. Apostle's Blessing as well. And the sideboard, we have some Dismembers, a bunch of Pyroclasm and Flamekin Harbinger, and the fourth Death Shadow, the third Slaughter Pact, or the fourth Slaughter Pact, and four Cloud of the Dominus. So definitely a deck that's based on blue and red, kind of just free rolling the Death Shadow package. But yeah, the oldest list with Death Shadow in the format that I could find. So 2012. Good job to whoever found this. Then we go to Kalea in 2013, and in 2013 we have this deck here. So what this deck is trying to do is, okay, I'm gonna go through this slowly so it's very clear. What this deck is trying to do, it's playing Death Shadow. So we've got that Shadow, and it's playing Avatar of Hope. And Avatar of Hope is if you have 3 life or less, this spell costs 6 less to cost. So this deck is trying to hurt itself. So far, so good. So what this deck is trying to do, and it's very much like Ad Nauseam, you're trying to Angel's Grace. So you play Angel's Grace with the Death Shadow in play. And then you Spoils of the Vault. And back in the day, if you went into the minus life totals, Death Shadow grew over a 13-13. That's not a rule anymore. It doesn't happen anymore, but it used to happen. So you use Angel's Grace and Spoils of the Vault, just like Ad Nauseam does, or did. And you go to like minus a lot, like minus all of these. Someone else can count it out. I'm way too in the middle of the night to do it. So anyway, you go minus all of these, and then you just go and where is it? Rite of Consumption, and this is just a black fling. So what happens is you go Spoils of the Vault, my Death Shadow becomes enormous. Rite of Consumption, throw your Death Shadow and kill them. That's what this deck is trying to do, and you have some other stuff in here as well, like if you have 5 or less lives that you and each opponent you control gain protection, etc. etc. So just some protection for the combo, some Thoughtseizers. So yeah, in the early days, Death Shadow definitely in a different kind of deck than it is in today. And in the sideboard, some Celestial Purges, Favor of the Mighty, Inquisition of Kozilek, Thoughtseize, Invest, and Cavern of Souls. Like this deck's playing 10 creatures and 2 Cavern of Souls in the sideboard and one in the main. It's God, I love this format sometimes. That was it for 2013. So in the early days, Death Shadow just didn't get a lot of results. However, when you get to 2014, there's more lists starting to come around. So we have a bunch of different stuff for 2014. So here we have Earldare 1. And this is once again a deck based on Killing Fiend, and yeah, you could basically call this Kill'em Fiend. So I'm fully guessing someone already is doing that. We have a lot of the fast stuff that Modern is proud of on the ban list as well. So we have Simian Spirit Guide, we have Cataxian Probe, we have Tainted Strike. With this isn't bad. It's just a spell that's +1/+0. So what you're trying to do with this one is once again with the Nif-Magus Elemental in the bottom here as well. So you get the Nif-Magus Elemental. You just play a one drop and try to get it big enough to either kill your opponent on the spot or give it Tainted Strike and just give it infect and kill them that way. So definitely just a get you dead deck and just some post-mortem lunges, some lightning. I don't know why this card isn't seeing a lot of play in Modern. This card is extremely powerful. Like I think people very much underestimate this card. Assault Strobe again, Shattering Spree, Pyroclasm, Post-Mortem Lunge, Dismember, Duress, Slaughterpack. So that's all pretty standard. But yeah, this is just the get 'em dead deck. And the other deck that we are just getting along in 2014 is a deck by No Pride. And this is very much getting to the point of ad nauseum where you have. This is just an advanced version of the deck we just had. So this has Phyrexian Unlife and Spoils of the Vault as well. So instead of the Fates. No, not Fates. What is it called? Angel's Grace. You get Phyrexian Unlife so you can do it. Over multiple turns, and this is just actually splashing red for fling. So if we go purely actually technical, this is the first Mardu Shadow list. But yeah, I'm not counting it as that. But yeah, fling making it the first Mardu Shadow list, or Spellskite making it the first four color shadow list. So well done. And for the rest, this deck, we are seeing a lot of the things that make Shadow good as well, even in the later years. So we have Path to Exile, just oodles of efficient removal in Path to Exile. Let's see, there's some Oath of Charms in here. I don't get why anyone would ever sleeve this up, but people do. People do the same with all the charms, and I think they're all unplayable. Anyway, Spoils of the Vault in here, some Thoughtseize, some Inquisition, so lots of interaction, and three Bitter Blossom. Just a good card. And Plunge into Darkness, so choose one, sacrifice any number of creatures. You gain three life for each sacrificed creature, so kind of a hedge for the burn matchup, but this is definitely about the second mode. Pay X life, then look at the top X cards of your library, put one of those cards into your hand, and then exile the rest. So this is just paying a lot of life. So you can get a really, really, really big Death Shadow and just fling it at your opponent. Sideboard, Stony Silence, Ley Line, Dark Blast, Bitter Blossom, Tech Edge for Thrawn, Torpor Orb for Twin. Like, that's super obvious. And the last thing people were doing in 2014, and this is by Stealth Pants, and I'm so inclined to make it Captain Stealth Pants, but that's not the thing, is another version of the Angel's Grace combo deck. So this is the Angel's Grace version with Path to Exile, Fate Shield again. And this is just a deck that did well in 2014. Yeah, there was a lot of results in 2012, 13, 14. But you'll definitely see in like 2015 the deck just zeroing in on what it's wanting to do. So here we have Pact of Negation added to the deck. So technically, actually, the first Esper Shadow list. I know, I just had to include it. But yeah, I think this deck is really cool. Just a rite of consumption, just throwing the Death Shadow at your face after you're at -1 million life total is just a really funny idea to me. So, Sideboard, Inquisition, Thoughtseize, Drown, Infest, Favor, Rest in Peace, Stony Silence, Avatar. Like, all of these are so obvious. I'm gonna go through the sideboards really fast because modern sideboards are the most obvious thing ever, usually. Then we get to 2015. So, here I do need to take care a bit of which one I'm using first. We start off with a PT Paul's list, if I say that correct. Yeah, PT Paul's list. This is a list from the 10th of March in 2015. And this is the first time someone paired Death Shadow with Wild Nacalle. And yeah, this was a match made in heaven. Look at this beauty of a deck. This deck wanted to get you dead. Also, a team of Battle Rage making an appearance. As I said, you'll be seeing a lot of this card, so. Yeah, here it is, first time. Become Immense is in here as well. Delve spells are busted, so we're playing Tasigur as well. So, zero mana spells. Lots of Mistress Barbel, Cataxian Probe, Mutagenic Growth, just 0/0/0. ton of fetch lands. Get those Delve cards going. Oh, Street Wraith as well. But I know this says it's a 5-mana 3/4 Swamp Walk, but that's all crap. It's just a cycling pay to life. And yeah, if you're ever really hard casting this, probably something went really wrong. So yeah, for the rest, Tessiger, Become Immense, just Delve spells are insanely busted, so yeah. Sideboard, Winds of Cost Sisma in here for the mirror or something, I'm guessing. For the rest, yeah, Dismemberst, Ozzy's, Apostle's Blessing, Infraction on Life, blah, 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 blah. We've all seen it a million times before. Oh, that's the wrong one. 3, 24, 5. I need this one. Okay, so here we have the actual first Grixis Shadow that I could find. And yeah, this is Ichen the Conqueror Lordin's deck. And I hope I said that right, but this is the first time that someone got the idea of just combining the red, blue, and black cost. Jesus, I needed a couple of tries for that one. And this is the oldest list I could find. So this is a list from 24th of May in 2015. And yeah, this is just actual factual Grixis Shadow. It's still very much working towards the shell we all know and love. But it's definitely getting there. Like, we have the Stubborn Denials in here. We have the Kolaghan's Command in here. We have the Dismembers. We have the Tessigers. We have the Anglers. This deck's still playing Pro because it could. Lightning Bolts in yourself, Thoughtseize in here, so no Inquisitions yet, a bunch more counter spells. So like these days the spell snares are gone, remands are gone, Mana Leak could be there, so the Deprivers might be gone. But also just 19 lands, that's been staple for years, one Electrolyze, not there anymore. But so in 2015 this was very much like the Grixis Shadow we all know and love. So very cool to see like a very old list of that. Sideboard, a Dispel. Yeah, like, there's a foul renewal here. I don't know why. Like, I get why, but there has to be a better card for this. Devour Flash is for Bogles, mostly, probably. There's two Slavering Nulls in here, and I think this is just booster filler. I think they were like, man, I have 13 cards, and I need two more. So they were like, oh, I need two more, and I'm just going to go ahead and take two Slavering Nulls from my draft pool and put them in there or something. Like, there has to be something better than this. Is it Static Caster? One of the other unplayable charms. As I said, I think all the charms are unplayable. So, do with that what you like. There's a land in the sideboard. I think they were actually kind of scared of not having enough land. So, they were like, I'll put one in the sideboard for if I'm on the play and on game two. And Spell's Guide and Sun's Droplet. So, very cool. This list also looks very fun. Like, this looks like a very fun deck to play to me. Let's see, 2015, then we go to 4, 7, 15, Deep Finesse, there we go. So on the 4th of July in 2015, Deep Finesse won the marks playing this list. And this is this is definitely showing like the early signs as well of getting towards Grixis Dead Shadow. Still the spell snares are here. Still the Deprives are here, Kolaghan's Command. So yeah, definitely getting there, but this is still just Grixis Delver. Like, if you haven't been playing Mono for a long time, this is Grixis Delver. This was a tier 1 deck. And you're like, wait, but Rob, I don't see any shadows. No, that's correct. They are, over here. They are in the sideboard. So Grixis Death Shadow first tournament win is 3 off in the sideboard. And you know, the funny thing is, us Delver players, I've played a crap ton of Grixis Delver. It's still my favorite deck. I even played it through the GPs where Grixis Death Shadow was just a known factor. I was still like, I'm going to play Grixis Delver because it's way more fun. Anyway, what we ended up doing was putting Grixis Death... So we ended up putting Death Shadow in the sideboard for the burn matchup. And we kind of accidentally stumbled on some of the best decks you could be making in Modern. However, what we did not figure out was to just dump Delver. What we should have done was like, yeah, this one, bye bye. This one, hello friend. This is what we should have done. What we did instead was bye bye. We still can't beat Burn. So bye bye, you suck. Bye bye, man. Were we wrong? We were so wrong. It's actually hilarious to me now. I still remember like having my dead shadows and being like, yeah, you can have them for like for a euro, and be like, yeah, you take my dead shadows for a euro. They suck. I still can't be burned. Screw this card. I don't want it anymore. And then just realizing that it's the best thing about the deck. We just need to dump the Delvers. Good times, good times. Let's see as well. Oh, on the same day, the Matsugan. Yeah, Matsugan on the same day also got a good finish in the Masters. He got fourth place. And yeah, this is just the other thing you can do with Shadow. And this is that Shadow's actual good first finish. So really wanted to include it, actual four of that Shadow in the main board. Mutagenic Growth's in here as well. Wild Macaddles in here. So yeah, grats to Matsugan. Well done. This deck looked really sweet. I've played stuff very similar to this in opens as well. Pact of Negation, Thoughtseize, Ancient Growth, Hooting Mandrill, and Nourishing Shore. This is just for the burn matchup. That's all I can say. Just Nourishing Shore, Exile. Like, let's see, what do you have? You have Become Immense, and just be like, ah, I'm gonna go ahead and gain 6 life. Screw you, and your burn deck is just great. Let's see, what else do we have? Yeah, this is 2015, and it's definitely the era of Zoicide, as they call it, or Death Shadow Zoo, if you're more sensitive to that kind of topic. So anyway, we get to 2016, and in 2016 we start off with, where is it, Smitsy's deck. So Smitsy has built a deck, and it's looking very familiar. This is yeah, the hybrid of what we saw in the last few deck list. And this is on, let's see, the 26th of April in 2016. And this is just Grixis Shadow again. Get the Forked Bolt, the Lightning Bolt, the Koligan's Commands in there. And this time we still haven't figured out to dump the Delvers, but we are getting there. So like, these are still here. Connection Probe still here as well, not for long. So anyway, yeah, Death Shadow, four off in the main. They were like, well, yeah, that Death Shadow card, that's definitely doing well. And yeah, the alpha players were just wrong. I'm not scared to admit when I'm wrong, so I was wrong. I dumped my Death Shadows. They didn't, and they were rewarded with it. This is the first Grixis Shadow list that I could find that actually had four Death Shadows in the main. So lots of stuff we still know and love today. Stubborn Denials in here, Saren Visions, Thought Scours, Thoughtseize, Snapcaster, Dismember, Dazzler, Angler. Like, we all know this stuff. I mean, it's still a deck today, so. Sideboard, Engineered Explosives, Spellkite, Ghost Quarter, like Tron is a thing even back then, Fulminator Mage, Koligan's Command, Counter Squall, PNK, Pyroclasm, Surgical, Diveblast, Thoughtseize, Hercule, Spells, and all pretty obvious stuff. So that's yeah, the first time I could find that four Death Shadows. Also, if you can play a list like this with the four Delver and the four Death Shadow, do it on like an FNM or something. These lists are a boatload of fun. Like, all of these Death Shadow decks are so much fun to play. Like, there's a million decisions going on. Every game feels really close. They make for excellent gameplay. Then we get to Matthew Kesselman. And Matthew Kesselman is actually getting really close to just the Grixis Shadow we know. And yeah, this is a list just like the last one. I wouldn't be surprised at all if Smitsy turned out to be Matthew Kesselman, but I'm not sure of that, and I can't make that claim in all honesty. But this is very close to what we know. Four Stubborn, four Thoughtscout, Death Shadow. Still the Delvers in here, but we are getting rid of them at some point. Sideboss, some dispels and stuff. But yeah, you can definitely tell the deck just inching closer in 2016 to the Death Shadow we know and love today. Something else we have in 2016 is Sam Black's GP victory. No, sorry, that's not a victory, that's a top 8. Excuse me, that was not a victory. And yeah, this is the all-in deck again. So definitely in 2016, you can tell that the decks are kind of coalescing into something beautiful, but there's still like two actual archetypes out there. There's the Grixis Death Shadow deck that's all like, I'm gonna kill you turn two if I can. And there's also the Grixis Shadow list with like the Delvers and stuff. So it's getting to where we know them. But yeah, they're still not quite refined, and there's going to be something really cool happening that's just like, okay, and now all of the decks are completely functional as we know them. Anyway, so this is Sam Black's list from GP Charlotte on the 22nd of May in 2016. Yeah, Delve spells are really good. So he has 3 Becomingmans powered up by 4 Street Raid, 4 Detection Probe, 4 Misha's Bauble, 4 Mutagenic Growth, and just, yeah, if you just pump it up and go, pay life, deal damage. That's all this deck is wanting to do. And if that sounds really simple, this deck is insanely difficult to play. So just be warned if you ever want to try this out. Sideboard, Hooting Mandrels, Tarmogoyf, Helix, Inquisition. Like, all this stuff's pretty obvious, so let's get on with it. Let's see, something else for 2016. Yeah, this is Kogamo's list in 2016. And yeah, this is still with the Killing Fiends, but this is very, very close to just being actual, factual Grixis Shadow as we know it. Some Mutagenic Growths in there and some Killing Fiends in there instead of Thought Scours. But for the rest, this is like 17 lands, Misha's Bauble. Like, this is really close to how we know the deck, and that's well found in 2016. So well done, Kogamo. Sideboard, your Spells Guide, and a Swamp for Path to Exile decks, Duress, Thoughts, like a bunch of discard. Dismember, Leyline, so lot of more cantrip heavy because of the Kill Fiend, but definitely getting there. So really cool to see this evolution from like 2012 to 2016 of people just getting closer and closer card by card to the deck. Then we get to, let's see, 2017, and we start off with 4-1, Matthew McCullough, and this is just his list, and this is just Grixis Death Shadow as we know it. Like, you could sleeve this up in a heartbeat and everybody would recognize it as Grixis Shadow. That would be no discussion at this point. So yeah, on the 4th of January on 2017, we got there. We got Fatal Push. That's a new one that really pushed it towards this. As you can tell as well, no Cotexian Probe in here, and that's actually kind of funny because on the one hand there's no Cotexian Probe in here, on the other hand Probe got banned like 5 days after this. So really cool to see the deck just cutting them and then the ban list agreeing with them. So Cyborg, Stomach Dinar Collective, like, this is all just things we all know. Like, this is very, very reminiscent of just our this week's Death Shadow list. Also, there's a Big Game Hunter in here, and a small part of my brain keeps hoping that the name Big Game Hunter is a reference to StarCraft. I know it isn't, at least probably isn't, but I keep hoping it is because I love that map so much. I've wasted so much of my life on Big Game Hunters. Anyway, so on the 9th of January in 2017, Cotexian Probe got the Banhammer, so no more Cotexian Probe. And what that actually did was, Wizards was like, okay, we need to nerf down these decks. So we need to nerf, like, Infect, we need to nerf that Shadow, because they were kind of doing the same thing of kill you on turn 3. And what ended up happening with the banning of Cotexian Probe is they actually made the Dead Shadow deck a lot better. Because everybody was just all in, pay life, look at the hand, pay life, make Dead Shadow big, kill you as fast as I can. Well, apparently in Grixis you can grind, so they made the deck so much better by forcing the bad card in Cotexian Probe out, and nobody realized Cotexian Probe was the problem. Like, this Matthew McCullough deck is the first list that I found that isn't playing Probe. So yeah, let's see, then we get to the 22nd of January, and now I need to look it up for a bit. So Oliver Hart, here we go. And yeah, now look at this list. This is, John Shadow. So this is what happened when they banned Probe. People were like, well, then we don't need the blue. Screw the blue. Hey, we have a lot of space in the deck all of a sudden. Well, let's play a Tarmogoyf then, shall we? So yeah, all of a sudden we had 4 Tarmogoyfs in the deck and still just 4 Becoming... Oh, no Becoming Mans in this list. Me excuse you. 4 Misha's Bubbles in here, just powering up stuff like Traverse the Ulven Wall. This is a card that got printed, let's see, god, which set is this? I'm wanting to say this is Shadows of Innistrad if I look at the picture and the art, but anyway, it's from a pretty recent set. And yeah, Traverse the Ovenwald really likes Tarmogoyf, and you know what Jund likes? Being lower on the curve and finding threats. So Traverse the Ovenwald in here, powered by Mishra's Bauble as an artifact, Lilianne of the Veil as a planeswalker, Collective Brutality as dumping your entire hand when you need to for Traverse. And this deck actually has four Tarfire, and Tarfire, you're like, why wouldn't they just play better Burn? And this is a tribal instant, and tribal does most certainly count for Traverse the Overworld. So yeah, you could very easily have turn two Traverse the Overworld activated with Delirium in this deck. Like, that was very real. And from that point on, you just started getting threat after threat after threat after threat. Just go like Tarmogoyf, turn three, traverse the Ovenwald, get a dead shadow, top deck a shadow, top deck a traverse, just keep going and churning through all of it. And this deck dominated for a while. It was really good. For the rest, yeah, some Lilianne of the Veil. So definitely still the Jund roots in here. So Lilianne of the Veil in here, Kolaghan's Command in here. Team of Battle Rage definitely from the Grixis Shadow side of things. But just 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 discard spells in here. 2 Kolaghan's Command. Oh, and you can also just use Traverse the Overworld to get Gorklan Rampager. So yeah, it's not the greatest. Like, your opponent knows you have it, but sometimes it just doesn't matter. If you're like attacking for 10, they don't have an answer, while they're at 14, you can just be like, okay, Gorklan Rampage, I kill you anyway. Sideboard, this deck is actually really cool. I love this list. It's like Traverse the Overworld. Oh, now I can catch Shriekmaw. Like, we're back in 2011 or something. Even before that, like, Shriekmaw was like, what, 2008 or something? God, I'm old. Anyway, Shriekmaw in here. So that's definitely not a card I ever thought I would seeing play in Modern. So yeah, really cool to see it. Liliana, the last opening, more Collective Brutality, Surgical Anger, Gnarwood right in here. Also, just another threat. This is from the Eldrazi set, I believe. I'm not completely sure. Yeah, I believe this is the set where Thought Seer and stuff are from as well. Not fully sure on that, but especially definitely from that era at least. So anyway, this is a 1-1 that also has Delirium. So if you're like against a Jund deck, you're gonna be like, okay, I need more threats. So board these in, and if you're against control, you board these in, just get more threats going. And yeah, that's what they're there for. So also, just going to turn one, do something. Turn two, traverse the Overworld for Fulminator Mage. Really cool against Tron. Still might not be good enough though, but really cool still. Anyway, then we get to, this was all of our hard stacks, Sebastian Pozzo. Here we go. So here we have Sebastian Pozzo's deck, and this is from the same day. This is also a deck from the 21st of the 22nd of January. Oh, and both of them got a Mox top 8 with this. So this deck just burst out of nowhere after the Pro Ban. This is literal days after the Pro Ban got activated on Magic Online. It always took a while. Like, the card got banned, and it took like a week for it to be active. That's not a thing anymore, but definitely used to be. But yeah, they just dominated this tournament with it. I mean, two top 8s with a relatively new archetype is actual insane. So yeah, lots of similarities here. There's some Vampiric Lynx here. Ghost Quarter as well. There's lots of cool stuff you can find with the Traverse the Overworld, so that's really cool. So well done to them. Then we get to, let's see. Oh, I forgot one. I'm sorry. So we have Ryan Leverone's deck. And this is a list from January in 2017, so the 28th of January. And this is the first Traverse the Overworld list that I could find. So yeah, I almost slipped into Dutch there. First Traverse the Overworld list I could find. So yeah, very similar to what did really well a few days after this. And yeah, well done. Let's see, sideboard, some Tireless Tracker, some Scavenging Ooze. Like, this is all really cool with Traverse the Overworld, just finding them and being like, okay, yeah, gonna find them. After that we get to, oh yeah, oh, this is a cool story as well. So apparently, when a bunch of pros play a deck on a GP, they do well. So at Grand Prix Vancouver on the 19th of February in 2017, Jos Arthur Layton won the GP. So that's why I took his list to do this. But Jerry Thompson got top 4, Sam Black got top 4, and Matt Cervera got top 16 with like basically this list. There's like one or two card differences, but it's basically all this list. And if you recognize it, yeah, that's because this list just did really well in the mocks. So, yeah, this, yeah, they just absolutely dominated that GP. It was a big GP as well. And yeah, just new archetype, lots of people in the good results, lots of money made that day. They should have been happy. They probably were very happy. I'm always happy to see Jos Arthur Layton on the Pro Tour. I think he's a cool dude. So, yeah, glad to see it. Anyway, they didn't change that much from this. Like, they took one Tarfire out of it. Added some Fatal Pushes, I believe. Let's see. Collective Brutality, Teemer, Tarmogoyf. Like, this is all very much like the list that we saw earlier. What they did change, however, is the sideboard. So, they very much improved on the sideboard, which is probably what got them their success. So, they have a Ranger of Eos in there. And if you're like, why is this deck splashing for Ranger of Eos? Ranger of Eos is something you can find with Traverse the Ovenwald. Ranger of Eos is something that finds a Death Shadow. So what ends up happening is you have the Leon, like, okay, I top deck a Traverse, what can I do? Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and grab a Ranger of Eos, when it's boarded in, obviously, not, don't cheat. And yeah, get two Death Shadows and just keep on plowing through like Jund decks and stuff. So yeah, that's why that's that. Also, three Lingering Souls. This card is a nightmare for control decks and for mid-range decks. So those were big at the time, so they added three of them. Also, Affinity, just Aethersworn Canonist and Kentucky Washwage. Just those are just for Affinity. There's no nothing else. Ancient Grudge, Grafdigger's Gate, like that's all pretty obvious. So yeah, they absolutely dominated that tournament with four top 16 results in the group of them. Let's see. Okay, there we go. And here we have Luis Susco's list, and this is the first Espo Death Shadow list that I could find. So this is a list from the 6th of March in 2017, so still early in the year. And yeah, this is just Espo Shadow. So everybody was just grind getting more and more grindy with like these Jund matchups, and I think they were just well, okay, gonna go ahead, play four Lingering Souls in the main. Which is basically the thing that Jos Arthur Layton did as well. Just Lingering Souls is the mid-range killer and grinder. So Luis Susco putting them in the main deck, four Snapcaster Mages in here, Path to Exiles, and the rest just blue black shadow, just Inquisitions, Fatal Push, Death Shadow. Anyway, yeah, first list of Esper Shadow that I could find. Also, one really cool thing is Anguish Unmaking. Exile target non-land permanent, you lose three life. Instant speed almost Vindicate in Modern is really cool if you want to pay life anyway. So also, I just love the design on this card. I think this card is very fun to play as well. Sideboard, Stubborn Denial, Disdainful Soak, Disenchant, Stony Silence. Like, this is all super obvious, so I'm not gonna spend any time on that. Then we get to, let's see, Grand Prix San Antonio with our all, everybody know this guy. This is Reid Duke. And I think he got lost or something. I think he just meant to play Jund but ended up here. Like, Reid Duke is just the Jund guy. So he what he ended up doing was playing a black-green version of the deck, being a black-green Traverse the Ulvenwald-based Death Shadow deck. And also just splashing in the sideboard for the white card. So just a bit more stable on the mana base. And Ranger of Eos, Lingering Souls, Stony Silence, just all making it to the sideboard. I'm very much guessing this is inspired by his friends from Channel Fireball. It's so similar, it almost can't not be. Anyway, he did really well at that GP, so that's always nice to hear and tell about. So yeah, this is the first Absent Shadow list that I could find. Yeah, Absent in the sideboard, so yeah. Let's see other cool stuff in here. There's a Murderous Cut in here as a delve spell. I would have put a Tasigur in here probably, but who can argue with results? So, and also it's Reid Duke and he's playing for Liliana of the Veil. Like, yeah, man, I am a very capable magic player. I'm very certain of that. But when Reed Duke is wielding the Liliana, I'm like, nah, man, I'm good. I'm not gonna argue with that one. Just have fun, win your GP, and just don't crush me too hard. Okay, thanks, bye. So, yeah, not gonna be criticizing that one too much. Let's see. Then we go to the 28th of May of 2017 for GP Copenhagen, where Mattia Rizzi wins the GP with this list here. And this is just, yeah, Grixis Shadow. That's just all I can say. Like, this is the actual Shadow like we know. There's like a bunch of Terminates in here, which is, yeah, not a thing anymore. But for the rest, just actual Grixis Shadow, as we all know and love it. Also, Flooded Strands in there. I believe the story was that he just didn't have Scalding Tongs, but it doesn't matter in this deck. It just really doesn't. You need to get either Steam Vents or Watery Grave or Island, so it's all fine. And Scalding Tongs doesn't get the Swamp either anyway, so no changes to the mana base whatsoever. Which is really cool if you're into budgeting stuff like that. Just look for things like that. I'm gonna do a video on budgeting at some point, so. Anyway. Sideboard, Stubborn Denial, Liliana, Collective Brutality, Surgical Anger, is it Static Caster, Grafdigger's Cage, Spellbomb, Engineered Explosives, Ceremonious Rejection. This is for Eldrazi Tron. That was big at the time, I believe, so that's what it's there for. It's also just really good against Affinity and against the regular Tron, so. Let's see, that gets us to something that's actually quite funny to me. So, something that happened after these GP wins and dominations and mocks open results and stuff, and yeah, the deck was just everywhere. That Shadow deck was just dominating everything to the point that actual factual Magic the Gathering pros were like, we need to ban this. So yeah, this is Luis Scott Vargas' infamous ban Death Shadow video. You can find it for yourself. I just knew that if I wasn't gonna mention it, that it would be I would be reminded of it by the chat, so just want to mention it. Look, just to make my point very clear, I think this belongs in the history of Death Shadow, but don't be like, oh, LSV was wrong. He's a human being. We all are. We all get it wrong. But it's just such a famous video that I couldn't not mention it. So that's why it's in here. Don't go bugging the guy about it. Look, he's a human being. He has done better than almost everyone on the planet in the game. So. Much respect to him, but the video is famous. I'm doing a history of the deck, so it should be mentioned. With that being said, we get to the 18th of November for Adrian Schrenk's deck. Where is it? There is it. There is it. Yeah, I can speak English, I swear. There it is, and this is the first list that I could find that's like a five color Death Shadow deck. And the sideboard shuffled back in, so let's figure this out really quick. So that should be there, I'm guessing that's from the sideboard. I'm guessing this is sideboard. Yeah, this is just a thing that Magic Online sometimes just does. You're like, okay, let's remove the sideboard. And then it just like, nah, man, we are bros. We can play 75 cards. I wanted to be a commander application anyway, so. Anyway, I'm guessing like these are sideboard and stuff. This, nah, probably not. Anyway, doesn't really matter. Like, this is just a five color Death Shadow list. We have Ranger of Eos, Lingering Souls as the white cards. We have Architects of Will, Stubborn Denial as the blue cards, Tarmogoyf, Thoughtseize as Team of Battle Rage is the other three colors. So yeah, this is the first five color Death Shadow deck that I could find, and he won like a small tournament. This was like a 50 player tournament or something, not completely sure, but yeah, they won, so congrats to them. And yeah, first five color Death Shadow list that I could find. And then I kind of skip ahead in the list, as you can tell. I'm like, okay, 2017, there's a crap ton of results, and I go to 2019, and that's for the simple reason that there was, on the one hand, a ton of Grixis Shadow in 2018. Like, there was so much that it just completely drowned out everything that I could reach. Like, if I had to go through every single list like I do did with the other decks, It would take me weeks. The whole reason this video was is late already is because there are so many results. Like I got hundreds or even thousands at some point. I went to look for like Dead Shadow good results in the period of 2015 to 2018, and I got back like 2,000 results. I was like, eh, this is gonna be a long video and a long week. So yeah, that's why there's only one video this week. There's just a crap ton of results. So what I ended up looking for was just innovations, and in 2018 I couldn't find much in the sense of innovation, but the deck was still just everywhere. It's just very good and still just there. And then in 2019 I found Vitor Horta, and this is the first time that I found someone that was playing whatchamacallit, Mardu Shadow. And this is a deck that's based upon well, Death Shadow obviously, and Mishra's Bauble obviously, and we get the Modern Horizon cards in the sense of we get Ranger Captain of Eos, and Ranger Captain of Eos is just like the other Eos card, Eos Captain Ranger thingy, the 4-mana one. You know which one I mean. I've talked about it a bunch of times already. Yeah, it just gets a Death Shadow, but this one is 1 mana cheaper, so we're playing this one because mana efficiency is king in Modern. Also, this card plays Dread of this deck plays Dreadhorde Arcanist, and Dreadhorde Arcanist is my actual factual crush right now. I've been playing so much nonsense with this card. I've been trying to do like, is it Wizards with Ancestral Vision. I've been playing a bad Grixis deck with like four of these, and it's been so much fun. I actually went 4-4 in the Shadow with my first brew in the challenge, my first brew of it. Anyway, back to the point. This deck, Path to Exile, in here, two main deck Surgicals. This is from the time when graveyard decks were just really big because of this little card here. There's a Fateless Looting in here, and this is one of the fair decks that's using Fateless Looting. This is not a deck that got Fateless Looting banned, but there were a lot of decks getting Fateless Looting banned. If your metagame requires two main deck Surgical Extractions because it's the best call to make, you're not in a healthy place. So yeah, this kind of stuff is like, okay, we might need to get rid of Fateless Looting. For the sideboard, just being in white gets you the best sideboard cards. All of a sudden you have Stony Silence, you have Celestial Purge, you have Wear and Tear. It's just the quality of the white sideboard cards is just so much better than the other colors. But yeah, this is the first Mardu Death Shadow list deck. Also to unearth in here, I just realized. Anyway, first Mardu Death Shadow list that I could find, so I thought that was really cool. Felt like I needed to include it. And then we get to 2020, and 2020 gets us the Good Soldiers list, which is the first pure Rakdos list that I could find. And this is a list based on Kroxa, Titan of Death's Hunger, and Dark Confident, because, well, Dark Confident has a very low curve. And there's some Death Shadows in here as well. So this is just a black-red Death Shadow list. Just no splashes, just base black, being aggressive. No more late-game value, just Monastery Swiftspear, try and kill you. Kolaghan's Command at the end of the curve. And you're like, why isn't this deck playing any Delve spells with four Kroxa? Well, that's because of, where is it? Lures of the Dream Den. I know that 2020 was the year of the rat, but in 2020, yeah, in Magic the Gathering was definitely the year of the cat. So we have Lures of the Dream Den here. Yeah, just dominating the entire format. You can find every single version of Death Shadow with Lures at the helm for it. It's just that good. So anyway, sideboard Deathwave because it's good with Lures, Collector Brutality, Liliana's Triumph because other people need to sack their Lures. Molten Rain for Tron, Kolaghan's Command, Soulguide Lantern to stop their Lures. Let's see, what else do we have here? Swiftspear, as I said. Oh, Seal of Fire and Niall's Spellbound is also really good with Lures. So first Rakdos list that I could find. It's from 2020, so. And then we get to, yeah, but to Tina, I gotta make sure I say that right, but to Tina, and this is just another version of the Lurrus deck. So we have Lurrus in the sideboard here as the commander. Oh, come on, do it now. So anyway, Lurrus of the Dream Den in the sideboard, kind of awkward with Ashe Yoke, but probably worth it. Plague Engineer in here as well, Collector Brutality, Renhen 6. Just yeah, all the good stuff from the last few years. Main deck, we get the Mishra's Bauble that we all know and love. Traverse the Overwall, Seal of Fire, Thoughtseize, Inquisition, Fatal Push, Death Shadow. Cling to Dust is making an appearance. This card is really new, so... yeah, that's just a new appearance. Very good card as well. A team of Battle Rage, Tarmogoyf, Assassin's Trophy, Dismember, Gore Clan Rampager, and the Street Raids in there as well. Wait, what? What? Oh, man. This has got to be a misbuild. I think they... okay, so I took this from the 5-0 dump, and I didn't figure this out until I was actually recording. But so what I think was... what's happening here was like they were like, okay, I'm gonna play Lewis as my companion. Then they entered the league, realized they couldn't reveal Lewis because of Street Raid and Gore Clan Rampage, and just 5-0'd anyway because, well, why wouldn't you, you know? So I did not see that when I was preparing the video. That's so funny. Oh, I love that. Also, Batutina, for those who don't know, is just insanely good at match. Like, I honestly do not have a clue who they are, but if you're ever looking for like a good polished list, well, not this one, but the other ones, just look them up. They are very good at the game. They are a regular Magic online grinder. I've played against them a bunch. I've lost every single time. So yeah, they're just a very strong player, and that's probably why they can make a mistake, be human, and be like, and yeah, Lurus, so new card, let's try this out. Street Raid, Gore Clampage, yeah, sure, this looks fine. Let's just go in the league and then be like, oh, wait, my Lurus doesn't work. And just 5-0 anyway. Oh, I love that, that's so great. Let's see, sideboard, some Veil of Summer, some Damping Sphere for Tron, Nile Spellbomb, Ren 6, Golden Scott. I believe I already said those. Let's see, I think I got most of it. With that, so do I need anything else? Oh yeah, there's one more card that I want to mention, but I've got to look it up. So Death Shadow made a friend recently. Let's see if I can find it like this really fast. There it should be. There it is. This is the card I'm looking for. So this is a really new card, and this is from Zendikar Rising. And yeah, Scourge of the Skyclave is just Death Shadow's new friend. So what ended up happening was just a bunch of really aggressive decks, like the red-black shadow deck. I'll pull it back up. So decks like these got like a bunch of Dark Confidence, a bunch of Kroxas, and we're like, okay, we're going to play four of the Scourge of the Skyclaves and just bolt them. So definitely a lot of very aggressive Rakdos shadow decks happening because of Scourge of the Skyclaves. And felt like I should mention the card. It's seeing a ton of play. This card is very good, so felt like I should mention it. But this is the kind of list that you find it in. With that being said, if you want to try any of these lists, you can find my link in the description down below to get a discount on Mana Traders. The other thing that I should say is this video is actually factually sponsored by Mana Traders. So if you want me to keep being able to do these, definitely check them out. Use my link, as I said. There's a coupon code down there as well. It's in the ad in front of the video and at the end of the video as well. I'm going to get the hashtag out of here because this has been a long one, and I hope you liked it. If you like the content, like, comment, and subscribe. Leave a comment. And with that all being said, I'm gonna go and get out of here. Thank you for watching if you're still here, and have a nice day. Bye bye.